across Yorkshire and Lincolnshire. And next we have the fabulous Andy Mossack.
The Late Show.
Across Yorkshire on the BBC.
Now, as a regular listener to the show, you will know our travelling man, our wandering wanderlust travel guru. He is Andy Mossack. He's been in quarantine for the last few weeks. He's been missing without leave. Evening.
Good evening, Jolster.
How are you, sir?
Oh, I'm fine and dandy.
Oh, we've missed you. I know you've had a bit of trauma, haven't you, over the last
week? A little bit. No, well, you know, I've had good and bad, so you know, that's the way it works. But I'm back in the saddle now.
Oh, crikey.
And I've missed you too.
Ah, it's so nice to have your dulcet tones wherever you might be.
Oh, well, yes.
I've covered my screen over, so I've got not a clue where you are.
Ah, marvellous, marvellous. Marvellous.
So you know me, I always start with the weather. What are we thinking of?
Well, we're talking very hot.
Oh, really?
It's fantastic. About 30 degrees here at the moment.
Sounds like under my duvet, Andy.
Oh, ho, ho. Dream on, love.
So 30 degrees. Oh, hope Mrs. Mossack's not listening. 30 degrees where you are.
Blazing sunshine. It's been fantastic.
Okay,
but they have very cold winters.
Oh, do they? Now.
Minus 15, yeah, give or take.
So are we talking snow as well?
Snow, yeah.
Right.
Yeah. So you've got very hot summers, very cold winters.
Oh, sounds perfect. Food, what are we talking about? Because you know I like to think on my stomach.
Well,
it gives me a good idea.
Now, Liz, you'll have to forgive me if I don't pronounce these correctly.
Okay.
Now, how about a bit of Cesnakova Balaya?
Do you know, I have actually got cream for that.
Have you?
And it should clear up very shortly.
Ah. Another walk.
What
remedy is it?
What's it? Yes, exactly. What's it called again? Can you say it again?
Cesnakova.
Cesnakova.
Balaya.
Balaya?
Yeah.
Okay. What does that consist of?
Well, it's a garlic stew.
Oh, it's what?
Garlic.
It's a garlic stew.
Soup.
Garlic soup?
Yeah.
Oh, very nice.
There is an amazing thing called brinza.
Brinza.
Brinza, which is sheep cheese and paprika and onion mixed together. It's like a cream cheese with paprika and onion. Absolutely delicious.
Do you know what? You must have a cast iron stomach, Andy, the amount of stuff that you consume.
Well, yeah. I mean, that's right. You do get a bit used to it, and they're all tucking in, and you have to go along with it.
Absolutely.
It would be rude not to, wouldn't it?
It would be rude not to, yeah. So what sort of things do they get up to in this place where you are?
Well, they have... What I is...
yeah. The place where you is...
Yes. They have the second oldest marathon in the world.
Sorry, is it full of old people like me, or is it...
I don't think you would even get very far in a marathon, my dear. But we're talking racing.
Ye of little face.
Olympic.
Mossack. The second oldest marathon.
Yeah, so the Boston Marathon was the first one in 1897.
And then,
they've been having a marathon every year here since 1927.
Right. Where you are?
Yes, exactly where I am.
Oh, gosh. Right.
They're absolutely potty about ice hockey.
Uh-huh.
And they're a previous... world champion.
Right.
Now, this particular country where I am, it was joined with another country at one time.
Right.
So the name was together, but now it's on its own.
Oh, there's been a divorce, has there?
Yeah, and quite right too, actually. It's a lovely... It deserves a bit of independence.
Oh, does it? Oh, I say.
Yeah.
So, look, this is what Andy does. He goes abroad for us, gives us loads of clues, and then you've got a guess, basically. So, yeah. 81333, start your message with the word Georgie when you text. Georgie.Spanswick@bbc.co.uk when you email. And when you call, 0845 303 3333. Is there anything else you would like to
tell us? Well, there's a couple of giveaways.
Oh, lovely.
A couple of giveaways. One is it's going to be the capital of culture in 2013. So a couple of years' time.
Okay, capital of culture.
Capital of culture.
Aye.
And then Martina Hingis, the tennis player. She was born right here.
Oh, I think that's a huge one.
Oh, it's a big one. And I don't know if you're up on writers. Are you up on writers?
Sort of.
Tendul Marai?
No.
No.
Okay. Who is it again?
I said the same thing and they looked at me like I was crazy. You've never heard of Sandor Marai?
Sandor Marai.
Marai, yeah. He wrote a book called Embers. He's a bit of a Kafka of his time.
Really. Oh, really?
Hmm.
Oh, wow. Right, okay.
And very famous, anyway.
Yeah, okay, lovely. Yeah, I believe you. Yeah.
yeah. And, you know, that's where exactly where I am. But I'm very excited because I've had a great time.
I bet you have.
Mm.
Okay, so the clues, yes. 30 degrees Celsius,
yeah.
Blazing sun, really cold winters with snow. We've got feza kovabalenya, garlic soup to you and me, or brinza, sheep cheese, as a speciality. Second oldest marathon, they've been running one since 1927.
Yeah.
When will they finish, I wonder? Ice hockey speciality. They've been joined to another country, but now they're divorced. Mm. And they're the capital of culture, 2013. So those are the clues. Martina Hingis born there. And the Embers author, Sandor Marai.
That's perfectly hails, said.
Hails from this place, What's yeah. Where You Is.
Where I Is.
Right. We will join you in a couple of minutes then, Andy, while all we listen to the Thompson Twins and Doctor Doctor, if that's all right with you.
Can't wait.
It's nice to have him back. Andy Mossock, he's our travel guru. You've got a chance to tell me where he is. Where in the world is Mr. Mossock? Twins and Doctor Doctor. That's a mighty cure, isn't it? We're curing all manner of ails this evening on The Late Show. The old wifier, the better. Now then, Andy Mossack.
Yes, sir.
He's still present and correct. It's lovely to hear your dulcet tones.
Yeah, likewise.
Our travel writer, he goes all over the world and he is in an unknown location and various guesses have come in, one of which has come in anonymously, and when I tell you anonymously, you'll know why. Is it Doncaster?
No.
We've got 30 degrees of heat and blazing sun. We've got freezing cold winters and snow. We eat sheep's cheese with paprika and onions and garlic soup. Second oldest marathon where he is. It was joined but now divorced. They've had a country split. It's been terrible. Martina Hingis hails from there. Also Sandor Marai, the author of Embers. And it's going to be the capital for culture in 2013. So I think I can read you out the what everybody thinks. So Howard, who's in Connecticut, he says Prague. He's definitely in the Czech Republic because they're the world champions in the sport. So that's one of the guesses from Howard. I've got from Phil, Andy is in Corsica, Slovakia. And Maureen says, is it Slovakia? Also on the old telephone. We've got Prague. Could it be Prague on the text message from Mark and Jane? They're still in the kitchen in Hull. They're drinking beer. They've got the day off tomorrow, Mossack. So Slovenia, says JB. I love it. Roy says, I reckon this is all a con and the Mossack Meister is actually in Barnsley. How dare they? How very dare they? I've got Richard in Halifax. He gave us a call on 0845 303333. He says, Herbenica or Moldova?
Ooh.
Where in the world are you, Andy Mossack?
Well, I am in Slovakia.
Oh, brilliant. Maureen and Phil and the rest.
And
brilliant.
Maureen.
Yeah.
I am in Cochise, which is, it's pronounced Cochise, but it's spelled Kosice.
Cochise.
Yeah.
Oh,
in eastern Slovakia, and it's about 70 miles from Ukraine border.
Right. Okay.
But it's brilliant. Well done. It's fantastic.
You gave some fantastic clues there. Yeah. Ivan says, is it Slovakia? Yeah. Yes, he's quite right. Yeah.
You know, Slovakia is... I'm really, really excited about coming here because Eastern Europe has always been fascinating for me anyway. I don't know if you've ever travelled east.
I have travelled east.
Eastern, yeah, no, I don't mean eastern, you know, kind of East Yorkshire.
Oh, when,
okay. Slovakia, I mean, it suffers, I think, from an identity crisis, you know, because nobody knows where Slovakia is.
Mm.
They tend to say, oh, is it Slovenia or something like that?
Yeah.
And, you know, Prague gets all the headlines, really.
Yeah, yeah.
In the Czech Republic. And Czechoslovakia, as it was, it became independent, you know, in 1993.
Mm.
And I don't know if you heard of it. It was called the Velvet Revolution.
Oh, yeah.
And it was a revolution because there was no shots fired. It wasn't a fierce battle.
No.
Or anything. Everyone said, okay, you know, you can split, and it became Slovakia on its own.
That's very polite of them.
Yeah,
isn't it?
I mean, it was really nice. It was really nice. But they've been a bit slow, being honest, in trying to catch up with the rest of Eastern Europe.
Right.
So coming here is a bit like going back to maybe what Spain was like in the 70s.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's, you know, tourism is becoming something they're really... They're doing it quickly. I mean, they are starting to catch up. But it's fascinating and very exciting because you feel that you're on the edge of something that's really breaking in new grounds, you know?
So what have you been doing then, and what is the architecture like out there? And, I mean, you mentioned the 70s.
I mean, it's Gothic and it's medieval. Actually, it's squeezed in the middle of Poland, Ukraine and Hungary and Austria. So it's kind of a real mix of people. And people here speak Slovak, they speak German, Hungarian and English. And I actually started off west side of Slovakia. It's near Bratislava, which is the capital, but I wanted to come out and see what it was like outside the capital, because, you know, everybody goes to capital cities, but there's a fantastic countryside outside. So I started in the west, and you know when we did that report from Budapest a couple of months ago? Well, literally, Budapest is no more than 45 minutes away from where I started. It's Bella, it's called. Beautiful chateau in the middle of the countryside called Chateau Bella. Absolutely fabulous. So you can have a couple of days in Budapest and then just drive 45 minutes over the border into Slovakia, come to somewhere like this Chateau Bella in the middle of the beautiful countryside right next to the Danube. And it's like just being in heaven, you know, beautiful, relaxing countryside.
And what's your bedroom like?
Well, now it's there. It was really lovely. It was all kind of Renaissance, you know, with these overstuffed chairs and chandeliers and all that kind of thing.
I love it. Overstuffed chairs.
Yeah, well, that's what they, you know,
yeah,
they call it.
Yeah.
Then I drove, went east to the east side, and this is where I am now in Cochise. You know, it's just a medieval town. It's got a fantastic cathedral, and everyone's out with restaurants and cafes in the streets.
And are the chairs overstuffed or understuffed?
They are very modern, I happen to say.
Oh, are they?
Yeah.
Oh.
They're very, very modern. And it's kind of no tourists. You know, there's no crowds like you get in Prague. It's just really nice. A lot of local people. Very friendly.
Do you prefer going to these little outposts?
I love it. I absolutely love it. I can't recommend places like this enough.
God, you know what we ought to do? We ought to have a little, kind of a little brochure of where you've been, so the out of the way, or a blog, or some, or a little list of something that we could put up, Andy. Because you know, we go through so many with you; it's easy to forget, especially when you're my age.
You're not wrong, actually. I'll send a list because I really feel passionate when you meet people here. They're so like desperate to meet people from the West, if you like. You get fantastic value. I mean, a beer is less than a euro.
Oh, for a pint or a bottle?
Or a litre. It's really good.
What? A litre?
Yeah.
Less than a euro?
Yeah, for about 90 cents, seriously.
Good grief.
Yeah.
Right.
They have Euros here too.
I think the whole of the Late Show will be going out there, you know. We'll be doing an outside broadcast from there, Andy.
But if you do come, there's a brilliant group of hotels. They're called the Historic Hotels of Slovakia. And they have these big old places all over the country that are kind of really character, big old kind of historic buildings.
Yeah.
So they're really nice. And, you know, they've got them all over the place. So look it up on the web and check them out, because they're worth coming to.
Excellent. And when do you fly home?
Saturday morning.
Oh, lovely. So you've got a nice spell out there, then.
Yeah, a couple of days. And then there's a food festival here tomorrow night.
Oh, I pity you.
Street chefs and all that business.
I pity you.
It's a shame, isn't it?
Ivan has just sent me an email. He says, quite frankly, I don't care where Andy is, but can I have his job?
if he only knew.
Oh, yes. It's a tough job out there, Ivan, and Andy's got to do it, basically. We'll catch up with you next week.
Indeed. Next week's a bit special. Great.
Really?
Yeah.
I can't wait.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Well, listen, you enjoy the rest of your stay.
Thank you.
In Cochise. Slovakia.
Indeed.
And congratulations to everybody who guessed. There are no prizes, as ever. We haven't even got any sheep cheese to give away.
I'll bring some home.
Oh, lovely. Can't wait. Take care, my dear.
Bye.
Andy Mossack, he's an absolute star. From where you